So this turbulence is given. And see, in this turbulence, bank is there, isn't it? Then cash balance is there, purchases are there, revenue, opening inventory, carriage inward, carriage outward, purchase return, premises, equipment, provision for depreciation of equipment. Then we have trade receivables, trade payables, bad debts, general expenses, property tax, wages, capital. Okay. So these are the items in the trial balance. Now see, we have these adjustments. Five adjustments are given here. Now considering this trial balance and these additional information, we need to create first what? Income statement. So first we'll prepare the income statement, then we'll prepare the balance sheet. So with the help of this question, with the help of this trial balance and these adjustments. So first I will prepare trading account for the year ended 31st March 2012. So in the trading account, first I will show sales. So let's see in the question, where is the sale? Sale, or you can say revenue. So see, revenue is here given $63,100. So this I will take. $63,100. And then I will subtract for the sale return. Now see, we need to find out sale return. Is there a sale return? No, sale return is not given. So see, I will remove this item. And straight away I will write this 63,100 here. Now see what I need to do. Now I need to subtract cost of sale. So see, cost of sale I will subtract here. So first I have taken what? Sales. And what is the amount? And for cost of sale, first I will take opening stock. Or you can say opening inventory. So what is the amount of opening stock? See in the question. So see here, given inventory at 1st April 2011. So this is the beginning date. And on this beginning date, we have inventory. And what is the amount? 3100. 3100 I will write here, opening. And then I will take net purchases. Net purchase means purchase minus purchase retail. So see in the question, what is the amount of purchase? See here, purchases are given at 42,500. So this I will take. $42,500. And now I will subtract purchase return. Now see the amount of purchase return. Purchase return is given, see here. Purchase return how much? $1,900. So that I will subtract here. Okay. So see what will be the net purchase. 42,500 minus 1,900. So this is the net purchase. Okay. Now I will take carriage inward. Carriage inward. Get my point? So see what will be the amount of carriage inward. See here in the question, the carriage inward is given. What is the amount of carriage inward? 1,050. So that I will take here, $1,050. And from this, now I will subtract. First I will make total of all these. Total of these three figures. Now from this total I will subtract what? Closing stock. That's closing stock. Closing stock, or you can say inventory. So let's see where is the closing inventory. See in the adjustment it is given. See here. Inventory was valued at $3,750. So this is the closing inventory. So this closing inventory I will subtract. $3,750 I will subtract. So see what cost of sale I will get. $44,750 minus this $3,750. So I got, this is the cost of sale. From, you know, sale. This is the sale and minus cost of sale, 41,000. So this 22,100 is what? Gross profit. Gross profit. Now this gross profit I will show in the profit and loss account. So gross profit here I will show in the 22,100. So we write here for the year And this gross profit per share is here. Gross profit I got from the trading account. We do not have gross loss. Here we have gross profit per share, gross profit. 23,100. Now I will show what other incomes. So see, where in the question is there is any other income? See in the question, other income is there or not? Other income is not there. So I will write here other income, how much it means. So see what will be that my total income. The same 21,000 will become 22,100, isn't it? This will be my total income. Okay, income. Because there is no other income. So same total income will be same, you know, equal to the gross profit. Now I will, from this total income I will subtract what expenses. So let's find out the expenses. See from the beginning, other expenses, see the expenses. Expenses you find bad debts is here. And how much amount? So this bad debts I will show here. And I will show 190. And after bad debts, see any other item. General expenses are there, isn't it? And how much general expenses? 1620. So that's 1620 I will show. Expenses, how much? 1620. Agree? Now after general expenses, see any other item. Property tax is there. Now see property tax, regarding property tax we have adjustments. See point number 3. How much property tax is there as per trial balance? 6,000. But see in point number 3 what is written. Yeah, this is property tax includes 1200 paid in advance. It means in this 6,000, 1200 is related to next year. We paid 6,000, but out of 6,000, 1200 we paid in advance. Advance means related to next year. So it means this is prepaid expense. So we need to subtract or we need to add? Subtract, because this 6,000 we paid, but out of 6,000, 1200 we paid in advance related to the next year. So I will show here. Property tax, how much amount we paid? $6,000 we paid and minus $1,200, because this $1,200 we paid in advance. This $1,200 is related to next year, not this year. So only how much amount related to this year? $6,000 minus $1,200, only $4,800. So and this $1,200 we paid in advance, isn't it? So the benefit of this $1,200 we will be getting in the next year. So this 1200 is just like our, is just like an asset. So this 1200 I will show in the balance sheet also. Under head current assets. Prepaid property tax. Property tax. How much amount? 1200. Now come back to the question. Now after property tax we have wages. How much amount? 7100. 7,100. And regarding wages there is no adjustment. So I will show the wages straight away. Wages, how much amount? 7,100. Okay, 7,100. So 7,100 I will show. And after wages see the other item. After wages we have capital, so capital will come in the balance. Now see the adjustments. And the first one we have done. Inventory, this closing inventory I have taken in trading account, and this closing inventory will come there in the balance sheet also, isn't it? 3,750. So in the balance sheet I will show under head current assets. Closing inventory. Closing inventory. How much? 3,750. Now after this we accrued in wages account. It means this is actually outstanding expenses. Accrued word is normally be used with the income. But if accrued word is used with the expense account, then it means that is outstanding. So see, how much bonus is outstanding? 180, that is related to wages account. So see, 7,100 is already there in wages. And 180 is outstanding. So we need to include that. Just a minute. So $7,100 I will write in the inner column, and $180 I will add, because that is outstanding. Related to this year, but we didn't pay. But in P&L account we have to take all wages, whether it is paid or not. So $7,100 paid by us and $180 is still pending. Total wages is how much? $7,280. And this $180 is our liability also, because we didn't pay nothing now. $7,100 we paid and $180 is still pending. So this I will show in the balance sheet under head current liability. Outstanding wages you can write, or you can write bonus. This is bonus is a part of wages only. So $180 I have written there. Now see. So second adjustment we have done. Now third adjustment we have done. And the fourth adjustment now we need to. Now see the fourth adjustment. Without the fourth adjustment, means this is the depreciation. And we need to provide for, we need to make provision for this. So this is just like a depreciation on fixed assets. So this 1920 is what loss. So this I will say in the income statement, depreciation. Provision for depreciation. And what is the amount? Again 1920. And now fifth point. So what is the amount of trade receivables? See here in the question, in the trailer's trade receivables, what is the amount? 5000, isn't it? The and this 3% will turn into bad debts. Yeah. So we have trade receivables shown 5000 here. And as per my estimation, 3% of this will turn into bad debts. So see, 3% of this 5000. 3% will come, 150. So it means out of 5000, 150 will turn into bad debts in the next year. So for this 150, we need to create the provision. And to create provision, we take money from where? From the income statement. So from the P&L account, I will take this money. So I will write here. Provision for bad, doubtful debts. You can write bad debts. And how much amount I have taken? $1. Now see in the balance sheet what I will do. In the balance sheet under head current assets, I will show trade receivables. Trade receivables, how much amount? First I will show $5,000. And from this I will subtract the provision amount, isn't it? $150. So how, what is the net amount receivable from the trade receivable? 5000 minus 150. So this is the net amount you will be getting from the debtors. And now see again the question. It means we have done all the adjustments, isn't it? Now I need to make the total of my expenses. So see what will be the my total of expenses. So my total of expenses will be this 15,960. Now from total income 22,100 I will subtract this 15,960. So see, this is my net profit. I got the net profit. This is my net profit. And this net profit I will add to the capital in the balance sheet. So I have prepared trading account, I have prepared profit and loss account. Now I need to complete my balance sheet. This is my balance sheet. So in balance sheet, see, first I will show what some of the items I have already shown. Now see, first I will show fixed assets, or you can say non-current assets. So see in the question. In the question, see where is the fixed, one item we left, carries outward. Yeah, this carries outward we have not taken yet. So I have to take that also. Carries outward. And how much amount? I need to do the total again. What was the amount of carry outward? Let me see the question again. 540. So 540 I have to take. 540. Let me make the total of expenses again. Total of my expenses will be this time. Yes, this is the total. Now let me compute the my profit again. 22,100 minus 16,500. So this is my net profit. Now I will prepare the balance sheet. So first I will show fixed assets. So I will show your balance sheet. And what is the amount of businesses? See the question. 38,600, isn't it? So I will show here 38,600. And after businesses here, just let me give the after businesses we will show equipment. Okay? In the balance sheet. And what is the amount of equipment? Let me see the question. 9,600. So 9,600. And now from this I will subtract a provision for depreciation. Provision for like we subtract net from trade receivable, we subtract provision for bad debts. The same thing here, from equipment I will subtract provision for depreciation. So equipment value now much 9600. Now what is the amount of provision for depreciation? See the travelers provision for depreciation of equipment given. So 3840. So this was the provision, and during the year also we have created provision. See, provision for this was the during the year we created provision for how much? 1920, isn't it? So this was the amount of provision till last year, and during the year we created provision with this amount, isn't it? So what is the total amount of provision? This is the total amount of provision, 5760. This was provision till last year. This provision we created during the year. So total provision 5760. So that 5760 I will subtract. Now see what is the total of fixed assets. The total of fixed assets will become this after subtracting this provision. Now see any other fixed assets. There is no other fixed assets. Only this much. Okay. Now after showing this fixed asset, we need to show working capital, isn't it? And for working capital what we do, we take current assets minus current liabilities. So some of the current assets I have shown already. Property, prepaid property tax, closing inventory, trade receivable, all these I have shown. Yeah, let's see any item left. See, bank balance is there, cash balance, this I have to show. So see the balance sheet, I will show the cash. What is the amount of cash in the question? $160. So $160 I will show you. And after cash I will show bank balance. So what is the bank balance in the question? 5280. So 5280. And any other items here? Beside cash and bank, no. Trade receivable already we have shown. So we have done, okay? Now, what is the total of current assets? I need to make the total. The total will come this. And from this total now I will subtract current liability. So one current liability I have already shown, how to study in bonus. Now let's see any other current liability. Trade payable is there, isn't it? 3900. So that trade table is current liability. So I have to show that trade table. Just a minute. Trade table. And how much amount? 3900. Any other item besides trade table? Yes, there is no any other item. There is no item of current. So see this is the total of current asset. And I have subtracted this current liability. And let me do again. You see, this minus 180 and minus this 3900. These are current liability, isn't it? So working capital will be this. And now I will add fixed assets and this working capital. The total will come this. It means I have this much fund, and out of this much fund, this much amount I have invested in fixed assets, and this much money I am having as a working capital. Now from this I will subtract long term liability, or you can say non-current liability. And in the question there is no long term liability. There is no long term liability. There is no loan. I have not taken any loan. The long term liability is zero. Okay. So it means entire amount of this 53,600 invested by whom? Invested by the owner. Now see, now I will do the derivation of this 53,600. Now what was my the opening capital? See in the question, opening capital. See this capital given 48,000. So this I will take first, 48,000. Now to this opening capital I will add what? Net profit. Okay. Now see what will be the net profit. See in the income statement. 5600, isn't it? So this I will add 5600. And there is drawing? No, there is no drawing. So there is no drawing, otherwise we would have subtracted the amount of drawings, isn't it? So drawing is not given in the question. See in the question, in the entire question there is no drawing. So it means nothing will be subtracted from the capital. So now I will make the total. So I will make the total. So see the total will come. See 53,600, and again here also I got 53,600.